Hello, my lovelies. Welcome to my channel. Here we are doing the love reading for all zodiac signs. This is going to be for Sagittarius, Sun, Moon, Rising, and Venus. How are you doing, Sagittarius? I hope you guys are doing amazing. Let's get into your reading and see what's unfolding for you in regards to love and romance. Now, your first card here is the Hermit card. Sorry, I was getting messages. The Hermit card, the Two of Cups, the King of Wands, the Knight of Cups, the Emperor, and the Ten of Pentacles. Partner or person of interest, the Ten of Swords, the Four of Wands, the Lover's card, the King of Cups, Four of Cups, and the Wheel of Fortune. Okay. All right. So the message that I was getting off the bat for you, Sagittarius, is a lot of you guys are going through this situation where you're trying to really tap into your needs and desires. That is something that came very strongly. Even for those of you guys that are in a serious committed relationship, I feel that there is almost like this feeling that there are certain needs that need to be met. There are certain desires that you hold or you want when we're talking about relationships. And I feel that there is more of a like a transparency of being honest with yourself and coming to the realization of what it is that you expect from a partner. And it's almost like there is this clarity that is going to be that you're going to be experiencing for the next coming weeks, Sagittarius. Now, for those of you guys that have been single for a while, I see you guys really, you know, open to love, open to finding a partner that is ready and that is willing to give you what you want when we're talking about relationships and partnerships. The Two of Cups is the desire to bring to you or to experience a genuine, authentic, loving connection with the King of Wands. This is, you know, really putting that intensity, that desire, that passion of knowing exactly with clarity what it is that you want and what you deserve, Sagittarius. There is love surrounding you, and there's going to be love surrounding you. Again, I feel that even those of you guys that are in a relationship at the present time, it's like for some of you guys, it's the realization that what I want and what I crave for is something that perhaps the partner that you're currently with is not able to give to you or won't be able to give to you. And it's like you being honest with yourself. And I feel that the more honest you are about what you want and not apologizing for it, is really going to empower you, Sagittarius, because it's bringing or it's pushing you, propelling you to walk towards a new beginning, a new future. Like I said, with no apologies, taking what it is that you want and knowing that you deserve this. With the Emperor card and the Ten of Pentacles, a lot of stability coming through for you, Sagittarius. Even those of you guys, like I said, that have been single for quite a while, the Emperor is all about structure. We're talking about structure when it comes to relationships. For some of you guys, it could be that in the past or in past experiences, past relationships, there hasn't really been much, you know, much structure. For some of you guys, it's settling with whatever it is that this connection is, just because we are not naming it or making it official. That's okay. We'll see where it goes. Now it's like, no, I'm not going to be doing that. I want to know exactly what it is that you want to see if it meets my needs. And if it does, we move forward. And if it doesn't, then I will, you know, walk away from that, going towards my purpose, going towards what I want. So I do see the manifestation of a loving relationship coming through for you, Sagittarius. Now, in regards to the people or person of interest that you're dealing with in regards to love and romance, we have the Ten of Swords. So there was definitely some type of ending. It could be that for some of you guys, like I said, you have been, you know, single for quite a while. For others of you, there's been a recent separation or breakup. With the Four of Wands, again, wanting the stability, wanting to date with purpose. And I feel that this person that's coming towards you, for some, the majority of you, it may be a new person. Because we do have the Four of Wands here with the Lovers card. It's like having the stability, but also the intensity and passion that you need in order to keep you interested, in order to, you know, keep you committed, keep you wanting to continue building on this connection. With the King of Cups, this is a person that's coming through that is emotionally open. This is a person that is willing to put the effort to giving to you, and giving themselves as well the opportunity to connect on a deeper level. You do have the Four of Cups here with the Wheel of the Year. I feel that for some of you guys in the next coming weeks, you may experience, if there was a recent separation or ending, I do see this person coming back around. For some of you guys, it could be that they're reaching out, promising you the world and the stars and whatnot. But I feel you guys, you know, really not interested, not willing to entertain that no more, because I feel that for a lot of you, it's like you are being clear and concise about what it is that you want, and you're no longer going to be entertaining anything that has in the past made you feel either belittled or made you feel that you didn't know where you stood with them. The Four of Cups does signify, you know, rejecting some type of advance, some type of offering. And I feel that these are the cards of your partner or person of interest. So I feel that there is someone coming back around wanting to offer you or declaring to you some type of love, some type of, you know, maybe even restoration of, hey, let's fix this relationship with the Ten of Swords, because there was some type of ending. But the Wheel of the Year is here saying, you know, what comes to an end, we need to embrace, because it brings to us new opportunities, new love, a new lease at life when we're talking about love and romance. You have the Ten of Pentacles here with the Wheel of the Year. If you go with the seasons, meaning if you embrace what is unfolding in your life at the present time, it's going to lead you to striking luck, to finding the person that is for you, not forcing things, but to let them happen organically, okay? All right, my lovelies, I hope that this gives you some type of insight, and we'll see each other soon. Bye.